In this module we will see Keystone version 3. So in the previous module you have already seen the identity service in OpenStack, that is Keystone, and what is that, how, what are all the utilities for Keystone, then how to use that and configure the Keystone you have seen. So in this module we will be seeing the advanced version for Keystone. So that's Keystone v3. So in this module mainly we will be discussing about the new features for Keystone version 3, then how we can do the pack stack configuration to enable the Keystone v3, then the multi backend support for Keystone, and then we will be seeing what all are the differences between UID and Fernet tokens and what are they actually, and then how you can configure the Fernet tokens, and at the end we'll see how you can use the dashboard to have the domain authentication and this multi backend authentication support. So let's move to the first point. So that's Keystone v3 features. So there are two distinct features added into Keystone v3. First feature is it adds an additional layer of hierarchy with the addition of domain. So still v3 there was no concept of domain, so mainly it was like project and then the users under the project, but in Keystone v3 it did a additional layer, so that's called domain. So now you can have multiple domains created in your OpenStack environment, and inside those domains then you can again create multiple projects, and then inside the projects you create your users, and then you create your instances and everything. So this helps you to segregate the resources and also have multiple customers access to your OpenStack environment, and you can keep them separate. So it's more like you are creating a subscription for each specific customer. And then the second distinct feature for version 3 is that it uses a different backend for each domain. So till now you are seeing like it was going with the normal authentication mechanism, but in this version it adds a backend mechanism also to the domain support. So now you can have like remote authentication method inside your domain. So suppose if you have two or three domain, one domain is for suppose for testing, one for your development, one for your production, so you can probably have separate authentication mechanism in those three different domains. So suppose one test domain may work with LDAP, your production domain might be working with your production Active Directory. So that's now possible in Keystone version 3. So to use the Keystone version 3 you need to make some slight modification in packstack configuration, and one more thing you need to remember here, in current OpenStack versions you no need to modify anything into your Keystone endpoint to work with version 3. So it by default understand the v3 request and process them accordingly, so you no need to enable or configure any addition endpoint. So that's one thing. And to use the version 3 you just need to configure that Keystone configuration file. So there you need to first edit it with that options, like you need to make it as a v3 enabled rc file, and once you enable that rc file you need to create domain in OpenStack, and this domain files can be stored inside the directory /etc/keystone/domains/keystone.domainname.conf. So this is the specific configuration file name format where it starts with Keystone word, then you put a dot, then you put the domain name. Suppose you are creating a domain inside your OpenStack environment as a development, so you put the name as a keystone.development.conf. So by seeing that naming format, OpenStack and understand this configuration, specific configuration file is for the specific development domain. So once you're done with this domain creation, then you create project inside those domain. You can have multiple projects, it's not like only one project you need to create, you can create multiple projects, and then you start assigning the users to the project to start working on this. So this thing we'll see in the lab section in a detailed way, so that you can understand how this thing works and how you can proceed with the V3 functionality. So multi backend support also is there, so it is possible now to use specific driver for each domain. So if you have multiple domain, you can have multiple backend specific drivers. So, and this each domain requires its own configuration file. To enable this multi backend in Keystone, you need to follow below sets of commands. So that's like OpenStack hyphen config hyphen hyphen set slash etc slash Keystone slash keystone.conf identity domain underscore specific underscore drivers underscore enable true. So this will enable domain specific driver. Then you execute the second set of command, that's that OpenStack hyphen config then hyphen hyphen set slash etc slash keystone dot conf then identity domain underscore config underscore dir slash etc slash keystone slash domain. So if you remember in the previous slide, we have seen that configuration domain specific configuration file path is slash etc slash keystone slash domains slash keystone dot domain name dot conf, right? So to define that your domain specific configuration files resides inside that particular directory, you need to set that option here by this second command, that OpenStack hyphen config hyphen set it is slash etc slash keystone dot conf identity domain underscore config underscore dir to etc keystone domains. And then you use the last command, that OpenStack hyphen config hyphen hyphen set slash etc slash keystone dot conf assignment driver SQL. So this will assign SQL as the backend driver for your domains. And one more thing you need to remember here, if you have multiple domains, so each domain will have a specific configuration file associated with that domain. So the file path will be slash etc slash keystone slash domain slash keystone dot domain dot conf. So this will contain the domain specific configurations. So to define your one driver per domain, you need to use the section identity inside your domain configuration file. So suppose if you have a domain called Red Hat, where you need to have the entry looks like the below example. So where you can see in the last two lines, like identity section, you can see inside a square bracket that driver equals to SQL LDAP. So this will enable to use SQL or LDAP as a domain backend driver. So here one more thing you can see, like it's you can define your LDAP server details, and then the user details to manage the LDAP, their password, and then the suffix of the LDAP. Then you can have some other options also set, like user object class, then user ID attribute, user name attribute. And if you want to use the SSL, then you uncomment the option like use underscore TLS equals to true or false, whatever you want to do accordingly your requirement. So then moving to the next slide, so that's difference between UID and Fortinet token. So by default we have UID inside Keystone in both the versions, like version 2 and version 3. So UID is small and simple, so it's mainly good fit for small deployments. So if you are planning to have a small scale of servers inside your OpenStack infrastructure, you can probably go with UID to define the various resources. And this UID is persistent, and because of that multi-region is not possible. So as this UID is a persistent, you cannot have similar UID for another resource. Whereas Fortinet token is reasonably, token size is little bit bigger and it gives you better performance and is a non-persistent. And the best advantage for Fortinet token is like it helps you to have multi-region inside your OpenStack environment. So below example you can see how the UID and Fernet looks. So whereas UID you can see like fairly small size, whereas Fernet is like very big in size. So this is the difference you can see between UID and Fernet. So to enable the Fernet, you need to have the configuration done. So for doing that, you need to configure your keystone with that command openstack hyphen config hyphen hyphen set slash etc slash keystone dot conf then token provider Fernet. So this will enable Fernet as a token provider for keystone. So once you do this enablement, then you create a folder for containing the Fernet token. So for that you execute the command mkdir slash etc slash keystone slash Fernet hyphen keys. So this will create the token container for your keystone and Fernet. So once you're done with this, then you initiate your Fernet token. So for doing that, you need to execute the command keystone hyphen manage Fernet underscore setup hyphen hyphen keystone hyphen user. You have to mention the keystone user here, then hyphen hyphen keystone hyphen group keystone. So you have to have the keystone user and group details ready to initialize your Fernet token. And once you're done with this all three steps, like you're configuring keystone, then creating the folder for containing the tokens, and then finally initiating the Fernet tokens, then you restart your keystone service. So you remember it, the latest versions of OpenStack, it now use Apache HTTP service for your keystone also. So to reload your keystone or restart your keystone, you have to use the HTTPD or Apache service. So now till now you have seen that we enable the domains, we created the configuration for domains, and we added the various backend authentication module like LDAP or AD or Radar IPA. But until you make the changes in your dashboard will only accept on username and password for login. It will not give you the domain details. So for enabling the domain also inside your dashboard, that's Horizon, you need to edit the configuration file, the local settings file, that's path is slash etc slash openstack hyphen dashboard slash local underscore settings. In this file you have to make two changes, that's one is like openstack underscore keystone underscore multi duo domain underscore support equals true. So this will enable to have multiple domain support inside your Horizon. And you have to also set an option like openstack hyphen keystone hyphen default underscore domain equals to default. So by default, which domain you want to use to authenticate via your dashboard. And once you're done with that, you need to restart the service. And then once you open your Horizon dashboard, you will see like left side picture where you will see like three fields. One is for your domain, one is for your username, one is for your password. And here domain by default it will show that default domain because we have set that inside the local underscore settings file. And this will, by doing this, your authentication will be allowed to use previously configured LDAP domain. So until unless you make these changes, you will not be able to use the domain features via Horizon.